Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. My name is Octoman, and this is the Let's Play for Epic War Saga relaunch in 2K18. Since I was farming this one rather quick, I can't shoot out another mission here, mission 2 in chapter 4, and we all know this guy already, so he is not a big trouble. Because, as you can see, Rhino returned, so we're gonna check this one out in just a second. We also are able to get a mess book as well as a water crystals over here, which we probably later on need to, but at the moment we just don't. For dailies, I don't have any dailies because it's still the same day, as well as I have a lot of weeklies to do for the next almost 10 hours to make sure that I get 50 crystals as a playing reward for mastering or for creating or making sure that I do all these missions. So as you can see, currently I have 35 or 60 done, so a good good time to probably do some here and there and increase all my things here and there. So I'm gonna have like 5 points left. Once again, energy became obsolete since it will be removed sooner or later. And what I want to check out is, well, this mission. So let's get into it. As you can see, this dude is level 105. I mean, we don't care about levels because, I mean, he has like 10,000 HP, but well, who cares, you know? So this dude is of type water, meaning we can use thunder units to damage him hardly. And also he plays thunder units here, as you can see. He also has fire units, at least two of them. I guess it's three in total, like this one. No, this one is earth and this one is earth as well. So the best thing we can do, take our little goblins here and blitz this guy to death. So let's get into it. Just use them. Make sure you have enough attack. And as you can see, a super clearing speed. No problems in using those little dudes here. Because he cannot answer as fast as we can send them all over. Because we are starting early, and as you can see, I just need like 10 seconds clearing speed. I mean, that is insane. And that is what you want to do as well. So you just keep on going, just repeatedly put in hundreds and hundreds of goblins, even if you don't need to. And meanwhile, you invest your points into a more and more attack. These dudes are going to become even faster and even stronger, of course. And as you can see, my little goblins already have an attack of 438 per hit. And that's insane. I mean, just, or I don't know if that is per hit, but I guess it is. So in relation to his HP, I mean, he has like 10,000. He has 10,000 HP. So just think about it. How many hits, if they are doing like 400 attack minus the defense, which is standing in anyhow, in relation to this, you can see that these dudes are extremely strong already. It's about the same like with my little hobbits in here. I guess I'm gonna try. I don't think they're going to be faster, but probably not much slower. So let's test it out. I mean, in advancing, they're about the same speed. They just don't have the same element, or the correct element, I would say. So let's check it out and see if they are able to perform anyhow. And as you can see, they are once they are under him. Anyways, because of this knockback he's going to perform, they are unable to hit early. And that's why the goblins, whenever they are able to go and push through, they can do so. And they can do easily because they are rather small as well as extremely strong against water. And as you can see, they just go here and do their job. And as you can see also, when you have that small amount of clearing speed, you can literally, I mean, you have some click time in between the levels and stuff like that, but in total, you don't need longer than, I don't know, 20 seconds per run. So in the end, when you have to perform this once like 30 times to master this mission to 300%, you're gonna be able to do this in, I don't know, probably 6 minutes in total, just to go to the next mission and master this one first, of course. And you're good to go, you're clear, and you can perform better and better. You get a lot of gold meanwhile farming all, or actually mastering all these missions without any problems. And you're gonna get a good amount of gold meanwhile as well. So later on, when it comes to gold and when we need any gold in any case, then we're gonna make sure that we have some. And that's the thing we want to have. So, as you can see, we are, or I am, extremely fast and just going through all of that. And I can easily, quickly go through it. You can perform the same. You just need to be fast and clicking, but I don't think that is going to be a problem for you. On the other hand, if you want to become quicker, I mean quicker in total, you can always use the shortcuts on your keyboard for the corresponding creatures you want to spawn. Like, when the mission starts, you can instantly tap on the T button, and you can keep on tapping if you like to, as well as on number 3 to reduce the complete maximum time. And maybe you're gonna save a second here and a second there to get even faster through leveling and through mastering all these missions over here. Okay, let me take a look where we are. Okay, we are at 220%. So as you can see, this really does not need anything. I mean, no time at all. We are almost done, or I'm almost done. I can do the rest on my own if I like to. So we can actually, or once again, talk about the arena if we want to, or anything else. So once again, I go here through, I just play it. I do the same speed as I would do if I don't record the video completely. So I just want to make sure that I get through that as soon as I can, as quick as I can, and to get even deeper and deeper into the game, to sooner or later increase our complete level value, or our creature value, by farming the real content. I mean the real good ones, like, so we are able to get the ninja assassins for all the ninja marks and all the other things we probably want and need for the future, for future content. But once again, as long as we don't have any problems in going forward, or something does not take longer than half a minute, we don't actually necessarily need to change anything. Until that point, we can go and keep on continuing with the units we already have, and we can check out any other units as well we already have. We can switch back and forth, we can change equipment even if we don't have to, because starting with a good amount of mana in the beginning, as well as having a decent attack on the items, on the weapons, is more than we need, I guess. And for the real ones, for bigger mana items, for mana plus L or even mana plus M, we are going to have to farm a lot once again. I believe, since we have, or I have, connection issues here, I'm gonna stop the video here and now, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I will finish up the last couple of rounds offline, basically, or without recording it, since you know what's going on here. As you can see, I have already once again a decent amount of gold pretty quick, no problems with gold at all. And since we don't need to take care of energy anymore, we can basically push or rush through like everything now and then, except for the arena things when it comes to weekly or dailies against winning or losing several different things. Once again, thanks a lot for watching and tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it, and if it's so, thumb this video up if you like it, and feel free to subscribe to my channel for future content. Thanks a lot for watching once again, and bye bye.